Hey everyone, this is Patrice with the Positivity Corner, and I'm back with another video, and we're still talking jazz. I would be remiss if I did not have this lady. I just love her voice. Her voice is just, it's extraordinary. She has several nicknames, and one of them is the divine one. Her other nickname is, of course, Sassy. I'm talking about the one and only Miss Sarah Vaughan. One of the greatest female voices of the 20th century, hands down. She sang jazz-influenced songs. She sang pop. She's associated with jazz. I'm going to talk about that at the end. Four-time Grammy Award winner. She had gotten a Lifetime Achievement Award. She was a NEA Jazz Masters Award. She's astonishing. Her voice is just astonishing. I don't know what else to say about it. She was born and raised in New Jersey. She started taking piano lessons at the age of 7, sang in her church choir. Her mother sang in the church choir. Her father played guitar and piano, so she had that singing gene. She loved popular music and the radio of the day. You're talking like 1930s, I guess. By the time she was a teenager, she was singing in clubs as a pianist and a singer. She eventually, when she was 18, famously played piano for a friend of hers at the Apollo Theater for Amateur Night. And if you've never been to Amateur Night at the Apollo Theater, oh, it's an experience. I need to tell that story one day. She played piano for a friend of hers, and her friend actually came in second place for Amateur Night at the Apollo, which is pretty damn good. That kind of emboldened Sarah Vaughan to try it herself, but as a singer, not as a pianist. She did. And she sang Body and Soul at the Apollo Theater Amateur Night. And she won. Sure did. And Sarah Vaughan famously said they gave her $10 for winning. And she was given a week-long engagement at the Apollo Theater and opened up for the one and only Ella Fitzgerald. Wow. Because of this, Earl Father Hines, who has been coming up a lot on these videos, he saw her, met her, was impressed, asked her to join his band, initially as a piano player, because she was a good piano player. And eventually as a singer. And that's where she met her lifelong friend, Billy Eckstein. That's a name. I might have to do him. My mother loved Billy Eckstein. Billy Eckstein left Earl Father Hines to start his own band and took Sarah with them briefly. She made a couple of recordings with Billy Eckstein's band and then started her own solo career, which was considerable. She sang everything. She sang the Great American Songbook. She sang some jazz-influenced tunes. She sang pop. Just wonderful. I think her and Ella Fitzgerald probably set the standard for everybody else during that time, especially the 40s and the 50s. You know, it was Sarah and Ella, and then it was everybody else. I'm just saying. Her records are astonishing. I'm going to play this one from 1955. It's from her self-titled album, which was critically acclaimed upon its release. And this standard was written by the one and only George Shearing. And it's just great. It's absolutely great. This is called Lullaby of Birdland.
Lullaby of Birdland, that's what I always hear when you sigh. Never in my wordland could there be ways to reveal in a phrase how I feel. Have you ever heard two turtle doves, bill and coo, when they love? That's the kind of magic music we make with our lips when we kiss. And there's a weepy old willow, he really knows how to cry. That's how I'd cry on my pillow if you should tell me farewell and goodbye. Lullaby of Birdland, whisper low, kiss me sweet and we'll go flying high in Birdland, high in the sky up above, all because we're in love.
The one, the only, sassy herself, Miss Sarah Vaughan, with a classic Lullaby of Birdland. Sarah Vaughan did not consider herself a jazz singer. She was quoted as saying, "I just sing what I want to sing, what I like to sing." And you know what? Thank God she did, because we got all those wonderful records from her. Oh, she's been gone for years. May she rest in eternal peace. But thank you, Sarah Vaughan, for the gift of that magnificent, one-of-a-kind voice. Wow. As always, this is Patrice with the Positivity Corner. Please like, click, share, subscribe, push the button, join the party. And I will be back with another video.